This humble office block is a portal to another world, one of self-respect, financial independence, and limitless opportunity.
Hello there.
Hello.
Because behind the closed doors of its interview rooms, lives are about to change.
You here for an interview as well? You're nervous.
Terrified.
Here, real job seekers from across the country do battle with real employers.
Lovely, thank you very much.
Are you ready?
Yep, we're ready.
All that stands between these hopefuls and the job of their dreams.
Why are there mistakes in your CV?
Honestly, I think they were just grammatical oversights.
Is themselves.
If I rang up your last boss, what do you think he would say?
Oh, he'd have a lot of stories.
Good?
Oh, no, definitely all bad.
Interviewing tonight, the luxury event organizer searching for a creative party planner to arrange lavish events for the super rich.
I'm looking for an individual that has gravitas, somebody who I can put in front of ultra high net worth people, so if you're millionaires, you're billionaires, and minor royalty.
And the waste disposal company looking for a new member of staff who will muck in.
I don't suffer fools gladly. There's nowhere to hide.
They say it takes just 10 seconds for an interviewer to make up their mind. These candidates are hoping they'll get slightly longer than that to prove their worth.
If I was chosen for the position, would I be able to start tomorrow?
No.
This is going to be your office today.
Fantastic.
Okay, thank you very much.
First into the interview room, one of Britain's biggest waste management companies.
My fringe is driving me mad.
The position, executive assistant to the managing director. The salary, £45,000 to £50,000. The location, London. Owner of the family-run business O'Donovan's is Jackie O'Donovan.
Morning. All are hard at work, I hope. Off your phone, Stuart, no personal calls.
A boss who has been running this firm for over 30 years.
I'm quite direct. People find that quite threatening. Not sure why. I'm looking for someone that isn't easily fazed. A wilting violet will not survive.
Helping Jackie with her selection is loyal number two, Richard Clark.
I wouldn't describe as a pussycat, no, more a leopard, maybe a little bit of tiger, but no, not a pussycat.
From over 100 applications, Jackie and Richard have selected these hopefuls on the strength of their CVs alone.
Doors opening.
The successful candidate will be super efficient, strong-willed, and have the ability to manage Jackie's busy schedule.
Hi.
Hi there.
I'm Dan Williamson. I'm here to see Jackie.
Very financial background, this chap.
There's no, like, personal profile on here. I've got questions about that.
I'm Dan. I'm 35, and I'm a business coordinator for a bank.
Where's the bathroom?
Just on your right.
Thank you very much.
No problem.
Got a bit of a crush.
He's nice. Hello there.
Hi, my name is Hilary McCormack. I do get nervous at interviews, I must say. It can be, especially when you really want the position, it can be quite a stressful experience.
The Irish factor there, that does help.
Yeah.
In preparation for an interview, I'd probably wear a good pair of knickers.
Good morning. My name's Asher. I'm here to have an interview with Jacqueline O'Donovan.
I think if you've got a nice pair of underwear on, you feel a little bit more fava-voomy.
Just wondering, would you like any tea, coffee?
I'd like a coffee, please.
Coffee?
Yeah.
A lady?
No. As soon as you bring his coffee, we're ready to run.
Okay. Are you feeling the heat?
I am. It's quite hot in here. I'm usually somebody who's really cold all the time. Maybe I'm just nervous.
I always try and do something slightly quirky. I put on a funky pair of shoes, something that people will remember you for, but is still appropriate for an interview.
Would you like to come through?
Thank you.
All prepared?
Oh, I think so. Well, you just don't know, do you? You just get a brain drain.
Good luck, Jackie.
Good luck, Richard. We won't need it. We're old cats at this.
Good work.
Thank you.
Thank you. Hello.
Hello.
Hello, nice to meet you.
I'm Jackie. Nice to meet you.
Hello. I'm Richard. Nice to meet you.
Sorry to keep you waiting.
Thank you.
Got delayed. Life in the fast lane. Right, do you want to tell us a bit about yourself to get you relaxed?
I have a very confident persona, but that shields the quivering inside. My name.
Yeah.
Let's start again. I've worked mostly in the public sector since I left school, so I have keen interest and keen experience in providing service. I've applied for a number of jobs since I've left my previous employer. There's not very many jobs out there at the moment from direct employers that suit my particular skills.
Why are you looking to move?
I've just been made redundant.
Oh, okay.
So, yes, so that's why. Okay. That's why, you know, cost savings again.
Yeah, budgets are cut.
Yeah, so when I saw this role, you know, I thought, yes, okay. I haven't spent very much time, you know, being upset about it and having regrets because life's too short.
My name is Hilary McCormack. I'm Irish-born and bred. I grew up in a town called Mullingar, County Westmeath.
If there is good rapport between me and the person that's interviewing me, generally that's a real big help because it sort of helps me to sort of settle into the process.
One of the great things about having an Irish connection is that we have connections and commonality in other ways as well. One is our work ethic, I think, and our determination to be successful at what we do.
You're right.
Yeah. My philosophies and interviews, don't fuck it up, basically.
A quick question, can I ask why on your CV there's no, like, personal profile? It's just a list of your positions and your qualifications. It's very unusual not to have a profile on the CV.
It is, and...
So who are you?
Can I grab some water? Is that okay?
Yeah,
is
far away, yeah. It's there, look, help yourself.
Sorry.
It's all right. We're making you nervous.
That's a good question, Richard. Why isn't there a personal profile on there? I think because I probably did that in a rush to kind of get the application to you guys. And but also, on a serious note, it's I kind of wanted to... I didn't want to kind of pigeonhole myself. I didn't know how to market myself to you. And so I thought, you know what, I've just kind of got this philosophy. I'm just going to be me and just be real. And that's kind of what you get is what you see.
We have a couple of tests to undertake.
If you're a newspaper, which one would you be?
See, I want to say The Independent, but maybe The Independent 10 years ago.
If I was a newspaper, I would probably be The New York Times.
Oh, right, good answer.
I would be The Sunday Times, because it has a tradition about it.
Guardian, because it's quite left-wing.
We do quick-fire questions so that we understand that the person being interviewed has a better understanding of the wider world. So if they ever get asked, say, in a social scenario, who's Angela Merkel, that they will know the answer, that they won't feel silly, because it wouldn't be fair on them, nor would it be fair on me.
Who's Jeremy Corbyn?
He's the Labour leader. Okay.
Leader of the Labour Party.
He is a Labour leader.
Correct. The Labour leader, that's right.
Jeremy Corbyn's the leader of the Labour Party.
Yeah, and who is Angela Merkel?
Angela Merkel's the German Chancellor.
Prime Minister of Germany.
Yeah, Chancellor, yeah.
The German Chancellor.
Oh, no!
If I was to ask you what one thing stood out on the job spec for you, what would that be?
That it wasn't just a support role, that there was a lot more meat to it.
I spent 7 years in Holland. I lived there, obviously, worked there, got married. I then got made redundant, came back to the UK, and then got divorced. I've been looking for work since February of this year, and I've probably applied for at least 200 roles.
So what made you apply for this position?
You don't find very many women who have achieved as much as you have, who have done so well, but also with such longevity. I think that's very inspirational.
So in preparation for an interview, I would do a lot of research on the person who I would be working closest with.
Taking on the responsibilities that you did from such a young age and having, you know, yourself admitted at 17 that you kind of knew nothing about the business and you needed to learn it all from scratch. That's amazing. I can't imagine being in that situation. Also can't imagine the amount of directions you are currently pulled in.
Yeah.
And still and the staff being standing. As well.
You use the word motivational quite a lot in your CV, or at least two or three times on that. So how does that work in practice every day?
So it's about being motivated by change, new responsibilities, being kept involved.
Hello.
Looking at their motivation and also being able to find ways of empowering them.
I deliberately get someone to ring me in the middle of an interview to see how the candidate will respond to it, because that's what happens in real life. So they have to be willing to accept that that's how my life is. So if my phone rings during the interview and they're disgusted, they're not impressed, they think it's rude, then they're not the candidate for me.
Although my degree has got an incredibly long title, it's basically graphic design and advertising. No problem.
Carry on. Hello. Yeah, so far so good, yep.
Well, I'm currently working as a temp, and that position is due to finish at the end of May.
Sorry, hello. Oh, hi, fine, how are you? Yeah, no, it's good, yeah. I'm just in the middle of an interview, so can I give you a call back? Okay, cheers, thanks, bye. Sorry about that.
That's all right.
Okay.
Sorry, I just need to take this, sorry. Hello? Hi, how are you? Good. You what, sorry? Yeah, wait, slow down now. Yeah.
All right, cheers, bye.
Sorry about that, Dan.
He can't hear himself, can he?
I wanna know what love is.
I'm impressed.
I know to show me.
Basically, I'm going to show you a short a page with a piece of text on it. I just want you to count the number of Fs on the page.
Grammar isn't my strong point. I can't be good at everything. And there's going to be various legal documents. There's going to be various contracts to read. We do a grammar test within the interview, and the purpose for that is to see what their eye for detail is.
10 seconds, off you go.
Sorry, can I grab some more water? They were really small cups. In fact, can I grab that glass over there and then I'll stop
cleaning
all these trees?
Yeah, that's fine, yeah.
Four. That's not bad.
Not bad.
There's 7. That's quite a high score. Yes, it's not
okay. 3.
Beyond asking questions, I'm also looking at the character and the type of person that's sitting in front of me. Because, you know, I'm going to spend the majority of my days with this person, so they have to have a sense of humour because I've got a sense of humour.
What keeps you up at night, Hilary?
Well, thankfully, nothing keeps me up at night at the moment.
You come across as a very serious person.
Am I?
Yeah.
Well, I suppose I think that I have to remind myself to smile more, because when I don't smile, I don't look quite as friendly.
Lovely.
Good stuff.
All right. Lovely to meet you.
And
thank you.
Lovely as well. Thanks a lot. Now, see you another time with any luck.
Lovely.
I would say I did a 7.5 on today's interview. I am actually very pleased with the way that it went.
I think she's highly intelligent.
Yeah, also I think she would be a grafter.
She referred to a sense of humour, but didn't come across.
No, I'm not sure if she would be able to listen to my laugh.
Thank you very much. And you.
Going down.
Is there anything more that you need to know from me to kind of make your decision like a bit easier? I want this.
Can you tell me, Dan, what's not on your CV that you can tell me about?
I had a very, very brief dancing career.
Did you? Strictly or?
strictly confidential.
Well, hey!
Right.
Waste management company O'Donovan are interviewing for an executive assistant to look after managing director Jackie O'Donovan. Three hopefuls remain in the race.
When I was growing up, I wanted to be one of Michael Jackson's backing dancers.
I remember wanting to be a ballerina at some point.
Oh, to win the lottery, to meet David Beckham.
I think I wanted to be a boy as well, so I don't know.
Everybody has dreams.
Why do you think you're suitable for this role?
I think I'm suitable for this role because I think my experience matches your job description almost word for word.
Getting this particular job is really important to me because Jackie seems, you know, a strong woman, a woman in a man's world, and that impresses me. Life experience can develop character more. Got a grown-up daughter. I brought her up on my own. And that makes you, yeah, strong.
Why do you think you're suitable for this role?
I think I'm ready. I think you don't. It's not. I don't have any training wheels. I think that.
Sorry. What do you mean? You don't have any training wheels?
I won't have any training in terms of like you won't have to tell me, okay, Dan, this is a project. Can you go make it happen? Like, I wouldn't need somebody to coach me that whole way through. Like, I think what the challenge here would be. Because I don't know how you guys work. I don't know Jackie, never worked with Jackie before. So I'll prioritise that to get to know you and know what you need so I can almost become that shield and then use my judgement because I think it's going to be a mix. Sorry, I'm speaking really fast.
I think the one thing that will let me down is maybe in a formal interview situation, I might just kind of freeze up. But then I think there's something human about somebody who is nervous. Like, this is a nerve-wracking thing. It's a life-changing thing. Like, you know, if you want something, then you are going to be nervous, so.
Why do you think we should hire you?
I'm very capable in what I do. I like what I do. It's not just a job for me. And I'm also incredibly excited by not only this role, but the ability to work with someone such as yourself.
Thank you.
Obviously, the basic level of grammar and spelling is important in this role. So we're just, again, another...
Grammar is not my forte, so I need someone
I'm pretty good at grammar. Yeah. I'm not sure if I'd be...
So I'll just show you this for 15 seconds or so. And if you could just identify, give you a pen, the grammatical and spelling mistakes in the following text. Yeah?
Yep.
Thank you very much.
You.
Off you go. Towards the end. Okay.
Oh, sorry, is that it?
Yeah.
Oh, sorry.
Just one you missed.
Yes, of course.
But not bad at all. Okay, I think you've done very well here. Yeah, four marks on that one.
Very well done. I can do grammar.
So we're reassured.
I only got a sin of the role. Sorry.
Yeah. There's no apostrophe needed there, so you missed that one. Your. And interesting.
Yeah.
So you didn't do bad.
Who would be your role model?
My mum.
Your mum?
Not just because she gave birth to me, apart from bless her. Like, she has four boys now in China, she'd be queen of the village, I think. Yeah. It's like, you know, I'll give you lemons and I'll make lemonade. That's what it is. It's that kind of attitude. It's like, go and throw it at me and I'll just make it work. And I think that's really, I will always be thankful for having that upbringing and that kind of resilience. Just like, yep, do you know what, give it, I'm going to make it, I'm going to make it happen. That's what I got from her.
Good.
All right. Well, thanks for coming in, Dan. Yep. Lovely to meet you.
No, you see, thank you for making the time to see me. I appreciate
Lovely.
It.
Thanks.
Cheers.
Right. Cheers.
Thanks, Dan.
See you later.
Thanks.
Thank you, Richard.
Bye.
Take care.
Really nice guy.
Really nice guy.
But couldn't see him. I think you have a real laugh with him.
Yeah,
but I don't think productivity would be very high.
It's kind of more like competency-based interviews, and it's just this is kind of like a different style, which is that's obviously what they want, and it's fine. But I was a bit like,
A real fidget, bless him.
There's nothing I can do about it. I'm not going to sweat it.
Was it that bad?
I could have done better, but
oh, no.
Yeah, it's all right. Yeah.
Nice to meet you.
No, you see, ladies. Yeah. See you later.
Take care.
Cheers.
Oh, Dan. Oh, I feel bad for him. You didn't give him a kiss goodbye.
100 applied for the position. Now only two are left in the running.
I'm really at a place where my next role will be my main focus. I don't have children, so it would be something that I'd really give my all, and it would definitely change my life.
Getting this particular job is really important to me because I'm getting to the point now, it's been, you know, coming on 8 weeks now, I want to get back into the workplace.
What interests do you have outside of work?
I'm a very simple kind of person in the lifestyle that I live, a very quiet home life.
Love going to the gym. I know that's
a bit like you, Richard.
A cliche. Yeah. I'm really into spinning.
I do too, spinning plates.
I'm a very keen gardener, which is lovely in this weather. I've got a very close-knit family. We do Sunday dinner every Sunday, well, most Sundays. Yeah, I think that's it.
So how would you cope with half a dozen tasks that you needed to prioritise and they all needed to be back to me by the end of the day? How would you go about that challenge?
Well, first of all, I'd look at what the tasks were.
Yep.
I'd look at what your priorities are.
Yep.
And working on what your priorities are is how I would define what the most important one was.
I think I'd work out which one was the most complex. If it was the end of the day was the deadline for all of them, which one would be the most complex and tuck into that one first and get that swiftly out the way or as swiftly as possible.
You may be travelling to, I don't know, Edinburgh.
Yep.
There may be
irrelevance of the maybes, how are you going to challenge
it? Oh, yeah,
you gonna
no,
tackle
sure.
it? Yeah.
Sure.
How are you going to tackle it?
Okay.
How are you going to get it to
right.
me?
Okay.
Whatever it is.
Right. Yeah, you've got six tasks. You prioritise them according to Jackie's priorities. And there you are.
Then if the end of the day was the deadline and I needed to stay later to make sure everything was completed, I would do so. Lovely to meet you
Thank
too.
You.
Okay, thanks very much.
Thank you.
Right. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Bye.
Hiya. How was it?
Oh, I think it went okay.
Yeah.
But yeah. Yeah, there were a couple of moments you sort of think, oh, maybe I shouldn't quite have said it like that, but no.
We had a good dialogue going. So, you know, hopefully she liked me.
How did it go?
I think it went okay.
Oh, good.
You never can tell, can you?
You never can.
I seem to engage quite well with her.
Nice to meet you.
You too. Bye. Bye-bye. I think it was fine.
I was concerned at the beginning. They grew on me.
Hi, nice to meet you.
And
nice
you.
To meet you.
Like her hair.
She came across very well.
And I think she could communicate quite well.
She really was a lovely person, and I think we really have found the candidate, the right candidate for the role.
I agree.
Good afternoon, Asher speaking.
Oh, hi, Asher. It's Jackie O'Donovan here from O'Donovan Waste Disposal.
Hi, how are you?
Hi, Tracy. It's Jackie O'Donovan here.
Hello, Jackie. How are you?
I'm very well. Firstly, thank you for coming for the interview the other day. Really appreciate that.
No problem. It was lovely to meet you.
And I just want to let you know that we thought you were very professional.
Thank you.
Brilliant.
We really like you.
And we'd really like to offer you the position.
Oh, my goodness.
We think you'd be a great asset to the company.
Are you joking?
No. We thought you were very professional. Yeah.
Jackie, very well I don't presented. Know what to say. Thank you.
Yeah, you're very welcome.
I think that another couple of years in an executive assistant role
would give you the experience that we're looking for, but at the moment, I just don't feel that
you've just quite got enough experience for the role.
Jackie, thank you so much. That's absolutely superb news. I really look forward to working with you as well.
I'm a person of faith and I pray about things, so I prayed about this and it hasn't happened, so it wasn't meant to be. But also I have a lot of other interviews in the pipeline, so I'm pretty confident that the right thing will come along.
She was very excited to that I was coming to join them, so that's a lovely thing to say as well. So new road in my life, great.
Entering the interview room next, luxury party planners Snapdragon.
So if there's anything you need, just let us know.
Sure, just lots of coffee.
Lots of coffee. I'll keep it coming.
We have to have the highest of standards because our clients have such exacting requirements and there is no room for error.
Boss Julia Dowling is on the hunt for someone who can dream up lavish parties for the super rich.
I'm really fierce when it comes to the standards of service that we provide. We put on some of the biggest, unique events all over the world. I'm very exacting when it comes to the skill set I need.
Helping Julia with the interview process is Doug Johnson.
I'm looking for a hidden gem who has got a great set of skills and a great personality that I think we can work with.
Absolutely.
The position, event coordinator. The salary, up to £24,000. The location, Knightsbridge. From over 200 applications, Julia and Doug have shortlisted these hopefuls. The successful candidate will be discreet, hardworking.
Hello there.
Hi.
And have an insatiable appetite for thinking up creative party ideas.
I am an atypical mixed heritage Londoner. I'm half Italian. I grew up in a place where they grow Prosecco grapes. So I am part Prosecco. So I think I'm right for this job.
It's leaking.
Is there someone coming?
Yeah.
I'm here for the interview with Snapdragon.
Is that a Harry Potter scarf?
That is a Harry Potter scarf indeed.
Is it really?
Yeah. my mum made it for me.
Do I have time to go to use the bathroom before it starts?
Yeah, of course you can. It's just over there on your right.
Thank you.
Catherine Himmer.
So she's the one who's been travelling?
She's been travelling for 3 years. Since arriving back from travelling, it's been really tough. You've come back and it's almost like you're going backwards in time. You know, you've missed out 3 years of your life and, you know, you're trying to compete with what other people have achieved in that time you've been away. I just don't want to be in the same position I am, like, 10 years down the line.
Are you ready?
I believe so, yeah.
Yep, let's go.
Hi.
Hi. I'm Hayden.
You must be Catherine.
Yes, hello, how are you?
Hi.
Would you like a glass of water?
No, I've had plenty of water. Sure? I'm well hydrated.
Well hydrated.
Yeah.
Great. When a candidate walks through the door, being brutally honest, they probably have 5 seconds to impress me. Why this role?
It's actually very interesting because, you know, when you apply for a job, you're trying to find something perfect for you. And there is always in the description something that you are not sure about. Mm-hmm. But when I saw your job description, it sounded perfect. I was born and raised in Russia. When I heard that I've been shortlisted for this job, I wasn't very surprised. My values are family and being successful in life professionally. I'm very ambitious and I'm very competitive.
Why Snapdragon?
Actually had a look into some of the stuff that you've produced in the past and like your featurettes on like Mad Online and other places like Hello Magazine.
The thing that appeals to me about the Snapdragon job, you get to see how different people within our society sort of live as well and see different lifestyles, which I find fascinating. I'm 24 and I come from Essex. I think I'd like to have some luxuries within my life. It's just something that really excites me. In terms of change myself, if I'm in a formal situation, then I'll sort of go to being very formal and very to the point.
I have to say, when I've seen your CV, I do like the little skills chart. How often do you update this?
I update it on about 2 week to monthly sort of process.
Wow.
So you'll be fives and sixes very soon.
I was going to say, you're going to have to kind of increase your scoring then.
And then like if anything that improves, obviously I'll update it and then...
Do you ever knock yourself off? Like a mark going, actually, I'm not there yet.
Yeah, I'd like to be as honest as I can on my CV.
Events are theatre productions without rehearsals. So I've got a little practical exercise, which is a little bit of fun. No right or wrong answer. Just keen to see, you know, how your creativity flows when you're presented with a creative challenge. We have a client looking to have a birthday party. They're a fan of surrealist art. Do you know what surrealist art is?
Not massively into art, but no, I don't.
Think sort of wild and wacky, things that are a real assault on your sense of what is normal.
So one of the things I'm going to be testing is their creativity and their ability to think on their feet. So I'm going to show them a floor plan, I'm going to show them a few mood boards, and then I'm going to ask them how would they bring that concept to life in that space.
I'm going to drag your chair away just so you can stand up and scribble.
Right. Wow, this is so hard. Surrealist art, right? Budget-wise, they've got about $250,000 to spend. Wow. And we'll leave you alone for 3 minutes.
I feel like I'm in a bit of a dream world with it because I don't necessarily feel like I'm massively qualified. I've got experience in this role, but the thoughts in my head are like, what are the caliber of the other candidates? Oh, I'm sure they're way more qualified than I will be for this role.
Surrealist art in that sense. Okay, you're just about halfway through your time.
I have quite a lot of experience being around rich people and celebrities because a lot of my experience is in fashion shows. They know what they want and they pay for it.
I want to come to this party. Sounds like fun.
So, stop there.
I didn't use your whiteboard.
Oof. I wish people could be in my head. It's a confusing place. I'm often baffled by what's in my head.
If it has to be surreal.
Give me an example.
Like a simple thing, you know, the tuna, which is watermelon, done in that kind of way, the sashimi of, watermelon.
Yeah, good. So actually, when you get a plate of food that looks very nice, when you taste it, it's totally different.
You don't know what you've got. But
So I think actors should be there because they sort of create this immersive experience. They can interact with the guests in a weird, weird way. Like, for example, people who like can swallow a lamp bulb or something.
like it.
I would create secret rooms.
I like the idea. And it would play beautifully in the dungeons. There were originally dungeons down there. So.
Which is amazing, you can play with it.
I quite like the flow of an event. People walk in, you can have like, I don't know, like these large mirrors that have got like the wobbly distortion? Because that's what another thing I thought was sprang to mind when you think of surrealist art, as distortion and changing your perception of what you think the way things are. So the table pieces, maybe like a huge iPad, if you like, where the partygoers can actually try their own hand at some sort of surrealist art.
Stop there, that's enough. Look, you've done really well. We've kind of thrown you in the deep end and wanted to see how you think. And actually, there are some great ideas there. There are things you could build
on. I love the mirrors at the beginning.
Yes.
OK, cool, thank you.
So the main thing that's sort of drawn me to this particular venue is just how sort of large this space is, and sort of saying like how to encompass like sort of a different artistic take. So obviously, coming here, you've got the grand sort of entrance that goes in. It's sort of inspired from a play that I saw a little while ago about the whole sort of refugee kind of thing. I grew up in a very working class background. I like to think that I'm very ambitious. The job sounds incredibly glamorous because of the sort of high budgets you can work with, the different kind of clientele. I try very hard to create opportunities to give myself experience to try and sort of climb up.
Right, imagine the sort of posh event loos came on site and overnight, and this morning they've been used by all the suppliers and they're absolutely filthy. What would you do?
I saw the posh event.
Loos. Toilets. There's a misconception that this industry is all about glamour. It's not. It's all about grafting.
How do we solve this? How do we solve the fact that these loos are disgusting?
I'm looking for somebody who understands that this industry is actually quite hard work.
What had they dirtied?
The loos.
Oh dear. Oh, well, if it has to be, I will go and sort it out.
Okay.
I'll do whatever needs to be done that needs to be sorted out. I'm not squeamish at all. I'm a hands-on kind of guy.
Good. That's the right answer.
What I'm looking for is somebody who basically says, right, I will go and clean them, I have to get it fixed, and they just get on with the job at hand. What I'm not looking for is somebody to say, I'm going off to find out whoever's caused the problem and to have a conversation about blame.
Well, if they're filthy, obviously you don't really want to use them if they've sort of been...
Yeah, but they have been used, so they're now dirty.
Well, I wouldn't even mind doing it myself if it meant that, it would get done.
Good.
It would first have a look and contact the supplier of them and sort of speak to them, and they're not of the quality that you sold them.
No, what I mean is they arrived clean, but they've now been used by everybody on site.
I'd get like an ensemble of staff on hand, say, like get like four people that are happy to sort of get a bit nitty gritty.
About pulling on the rubber gloves yourself.
The reason why we ask you that is because even I will go in and clean the loos and make sure that throughout the evening they're absolutely pristine.
Yeah. If I had to change your trousers and something that wasn't what I was going to be wearing in the evening, I'd happily go ahead and clean up and make sure everything's perfect.
Well, thank you so much for your time. It's been very
interesting.
Good
luck with the rest of the process, and thank you very much for coming in. Much appreciated.
Aidan, lovely to meet you.
Lovely to meet you too, Juliet.
Take
care. Bye-bye.
I actually thought he thought on his feet quite well.
He's bright.
Quite bright. Yeah.
He's very bright.
Hi. We looked after your scarf for you.
Oh, thank you. That's really kind.
You're welcome.
Hi. Well, that was fun. That was really interesting. I really enjoyed that.
One of the things that I kind of thought about, which is, can he actually graft, on site?
I hope I've got the job. I'm really... If anything, I'm really proud of myself for getting this far to begin with.
He floundered around the clean toilet question, didn't he?
Oh, he did, yeah.
We're obviously going to reference check you. We're going to talk to some former employers. Everybody has skeletons in their cupboard. No one's perfect. What are we going to discover when we speak to some of your referees?
There's a massive leak out the back.
No one touched it, it's just...
No! It exploded, Eric.
Yeah, thank you.
See? It's fine. Thanks, Eric.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe you should just stay here all day.
Luxury party planners Snapdragon are nearing the end of their search for a new event coordinator.
So one of the last questions that we'll ask the candidate is, if I rang your boss up right now, what would they say about you? It sometimes catches people off guard. So when I ask that question, some people squirm and get slightly stressed. Others are incredibly confident and smile because they know what the right answer is going to be.
Well, it depends on what kind of referees I'm giving you.
Sure. What would they say about you?
Oh, I'm not too sure. Well, I'm really loyal, I'm really reliable. I will never let that company down. I don't call in sick, things like that. I can be counted on. With regards to my actual ethic and day-to-day work, I'm always positive, I'm upbeat.
If I rang up your last boss, your last manager, what do you think he would say?
Oh, he'd have a lot of stories.
Good?
Oh, no, definitely all bad.
Okay, so if we take a different boss then from a previous job, what would they say if I rang them up and said?
Another bad example, unfortunately. I'm colourful.
Karim,
thank you
been
very
a
much. Yes, thank you for your honesty.
I appreciate that. In fact, both of us really appreciate you being very frank with us. Thank you very much. Good luck. Take care.
Thank you very much.
We've done a lot of interviews in our time. I have never come across somebody so honest.
How was that for you?
I need a sweet. Fumbled a bit.
That's all right.
You get tongue-tied sometimes.
Can you see him fitting in with our team? I can't.
No.
I am a very honest person, to a fault at some point. I hope to hear back from them. And yeah, I'm fairly positive on this. Yeah.
Julia and Doug now have just two to choose from.
If I got this job, wow. Oh my God. I feel like it would be too good to be true. Did I just get that? There is not that much feeling that compares to getting a job that you really want.
I'll be incredibly happy. It is very important for me to make my parents proud.
If I asked you the question, why should we give you this job? What would you say?
I really want to grow. I really do. I don't want to be stagnant in some way. I don't want to be like, is this the right role for me? I don't want to doubt anything now. I want to be really sure.
I'm very talented, but like at some point, I have to meet someone who would believe in me and like help me.
I think Julia has a fairly defined view of what she's looking for, which you perhaps could describe as a mini-me. She's more likely to go with the safe option, and I'm more likely to go with the wildcard candidate.
It makes me feel excited, and it's like, right, what can I do now to put my stamp on things? And, you know, you always want to go and create my own event for us to really start. Yeah. Gentlemen, for his 50th birthday now.
You don't get a job, not because you are bad, but because someone was a little bit more experienced.
I want my creativity and passion to finally show.
Well, it's coming through now.
Oh, so, thank you.
Thank you very much for your time, Catherine. That's really
thank you very much for
meeting me. Good luck with the rest of the process. Lovely to meet you.
OK, thank you very much for your time. Thank you. It was nice to meet you. Hi.
What she pulled up on that flip chart in those 2 minutes was impressive.
Well, I wrote down a few of the ideas thinking, you know what, they're actually very good.
I think it went great, actually. I really enjoyed it because the atmosphere was very nice, very friendly.
I think it went okay. Yes, it went well, though. So, I mean, yeah, lots of laughter and things like that. So, yeah, I think it went well. Fingers crossed.
See you later. Cheers, guys. Thanks.
Thank
bye-bye.
Bring in at 6:30.
Oh my God. Hello?
Hello, Dasha. It's Julia Downing calling from Snapdragon. How are you?
How are you? I'm very good, thank you.
Joined by Doug Johnson next to me.
Hi.
Hi, how are you?
We really enjoyed meeting you. I think it was a very interesting conversation that we had. You are very positive as an individual and you've got a really good can-do attitude, which we really, really like.
I called your referees yesterday. They were all very positive about you. And one of them particularly said she almost jealous if we were to offer you a job.
I'm delighted to say
that we would love to offer you the role. And would you accept?
Yes! Yes, absolutely.
Thank you so much. Oh my God. Oh my God. I'm crying.
We aren't quite sure whether the luxury event space is right for you. And with no experience, it could be a little bit overwhelming, I think.
And it's going to be the right job out there for me somewhere.
I got a job.
Absolutely fantastic. I'm so proud of you, sweetie. I'm so, so proud.
Interviewing next time.
Right, I'll do a bit of yoga.
Yeah, good idea.
The trendy London PR agency.
How did you decide what to wear today?
And the Essex car leasing company looking for someone to go that extra mile.
Ready for the interrogation?
Ready as I'll ever be.
Bless you.